Okay, good morning, all of you. I usually go for a lot of mission trip, and this was the longest mission trip that we went for in Chhattisgarh in Baloda Bazaar. And we do minister in the gifts of spirit, but I was not very sure about things. But so many miracles and healings happened. For example, there was one child who had only one foot was, you know, straight, and one foot was sort of, it was not straight. And as soon as we prayed for the child, he was completely healed. There was a child who was not able to hear for 5 years, and as soon as we prayed for him, he was completely healed. And there were so many miracles like that happening, and I think it was God's way of telling me that, you know, I still heal and you need to believe in me. So I think that's a beautiful way for God's way to tell me to increase my faith in him. Of course, on the last day, it was very exciting because I was preaching in the church, and then suddenly I saw some people with mics and camera, and I was like, I just looked at Pastor and I was like, is this what usually happens on Sunday? And then we realized that they were the Bajrang Dal people who had come. So they were extremely agitated, and they were extremely, angry that we were having a church service. Of course, they broke the church doors as well, which were made of glass. And it was very scary for me because I've read, of course, about persecution in the Bible, and you hear about stories. But when you sort of live it there, it's pretty scary. I was scared. The media came, and the police also came, and they started questioning all of us. And I told Ravli, I looked at her, and I was like, you know what? We look so different from other people. We don't even know how to speak the local language. And I was just praying to God that nobody comes and asks us questions, because I didn't want to lie where I'm from. So they came right next to me, and they just turned back, and they went off. And I was like, oh, thank God. I was like, oh, they didn't ask us any questions. But it's just like how it happens in the movies and how you imagine it to be. It was like that. But it's definitely, I think what I learned from there was, of course, from the villages, you, of course, learn to be extremely humble and appreciate their simple life and their simple faith in God, just childlike faith in God. And also living amidst persecution and still being able to believe in God. And the women believers there are so strong. They're like ready to go fight for Jesus. I mean, of course, there are men, but not so much. But the women are like all ready and charged up for God. And I think that's amazing for me to see. So I think every mission trip teaches us something. But of course, this mission trip was definitely very, very different from the others one that we've been to. Very challenging, of course, with the heat and everything else. But you just learn how to preach God's word in the midst of challenges. So I encourage all the people who don't go on mission trip, please go for one. It's definitely exciting. It will challenge you to be better in your faith and increase your faith in God.
Praise the Lord. I'm Himoshri Sarkar, and he's my dad. We are from West Bengal, from the north side of Bengal. So we have come for here for checkup in Nimans because 2 months before he had a stroke and he could not speak anything. Suddenly his voice got stopped. And we all were worried, we all were tensed, and we came here for checkup. And the doctor said that you just practice hymns and all, it's nothing much. It's just because of the tension. And we were like praying for him every time. And today suddenly when we were praying, and as the prayer stopped, he started speaking. And it's all because of the glory of God. So we thank him. And he's a pastor. He works among Muslims. He's a Muslim minister. He takes 3 days of seminar, and that whoever comes, at least 9 or if 10 people comes, 9 people says yes to Jesus, to accept Christ. His name is Pavitra Sarkar.
All right, let's just pray for him, all right? Let's stretch our hands together. Father, we just thank you for what you've done for him this morning, God. And we just speak complete wholeness. Holy Spirit, touch him completely. Every part of his body, in the name of Jesus, we declare it whole. And God, that he goes back to his place completely whole, restored by the power of the Holy Spirit. Even now, will the power of the Holy Spirit flow through his entire body. Thank you for what happened this morning. And God, continue to use him for your glory, God. We thank you, Lord Jesus. Amen.